So I'm sitting in a Freightliner Cascadia NextGen truck, and I want to talk about engine lights and regen lights and give you some tips on what to do if those pop up and what they mean, because that can be a little stressful when you get some engine lights and you're not exactly sure what to do about them. I can't tell you what every code's going to mean, but I can tell you what you can do to react initially so that you can feel comfortable knowing that you're not going to have your truck blow up, I guess you could say. Now, this Freightliner has a Detroit engine in it. I'm not exactly sure if the lights act exactly the same way in a Cummins engine, but I do know that they work for sure with Detroit, and it also works, these lights and the way that they come on, in Cascadias back to like 2016. It's 2021 right now. I'm sitting in a 2018 truck, and they've been really consistent with the process. So even if you're in the one with the older style dash, this will still benefit you by understanding the process that these lights go through. When it comes to the engine, we're going to talk about service soon, service now, stop now. When the regen system, we'll talk about when can you regen, when can you drive, and when have you got a bad filter. The information will be pulled from these cards that you get when you get a new truck. These are super helpful. They don't give you all the details, but they do give you a good place to start, and then the information that we have as we've worked with shops and troubleshoot many of our Freightliners over the past few years. So let's talk engine lights to begin. The first one is the malfunction indicator lamp, or the mill lamp as they call it. Now I'm going to show you some of these that I took a picture when I turned on the truck, because I can't make these lights pop up on the dash, but here's where it shows up on this particular truck. If this light is on, it just means service soon, meaning we've detected something a little out of whack. We need to get it checked out. You could even drive for the rest of the week usually with those lights on. You can also try another trick, which is that light will come on if a sensor picked up something it didn't like. So you can try cycling the key 3 times, because that will tell the computer to recheck those systems. Turn the key off, let it sit for 60 seconds. Turn the key on, start the truck, let it sit for 60 seconds. Repeat that process 3 times. If everything's fine, it'll actually turn the mill light off, which is convenient. So give that a try. Now, that light can also be the precursor to if something's gonna get worse though. So it doesn't mean that nothing bad's gonna happen. It just means you should probably get this checked out soon if it doesn't go away after doing the key cycle thing. So just be aware that it's the precursor to something coming up, but don't panic, nothing's that wrong right now. The next phase is when it goes service now. That's when you get the mill light as well as the check engine light together. That means it's detected a bigger problem. You might have an hour, you might have all day. Get it to a shop as soon as you can. Don't pass a shop thinking that you'll just get it resolved another time. These don't go away usually. You got to get them resolved. And then the last one being is if you get the stop engine lamp, of course that's the worst. It'll shut the truck down and then you're dead in the water. Now, what do you do about understanding what codes you actually have? You can't really pull that information off the dash. It gives you very limited info. What I highly recommend is you need to get the virtual tech service. It's about $150 a year, or at least that's what we pay at our company. And it sends you an email as soon as the code comes on. And it gives way detailed information on what's going on and detailed information about what it thinks the problem is and what to do to resolve it. So virtual tech, contact Freightliner about getting set up on that system. It's well worth it. That's engine lights. Let's talk about the regen system now and what those mean. Let's say you idled all night, you woke up and you got the regen light on. It's on solid. This guy right here, DPF regeneration lamp. If it's on solid, you have 2 options. First off, you can run a regen. In these next gens, it's super convenient. The screen right here on your dash, it'll pop up and just say, hey, you need to run a regen. Why don't you click OK and start this? Couldn't be easier. On the previous Cascadias, cycle your parking brake, make sure your cruise control's off, and then push and hold that button to start your regen. That's option number one. Option number two is with the solid regen light, you can get on the highway, and as long as you're gonna drive at highway speeds for a while, just go, and it will run the regen while you're driving. So that can save you some time instead of having to sit there and wait for a regen if you don't have time to wait. The next phase is if that same light is flashing. Flashing means the filter's plugged more and it needs to do a more thorough burnout. You cannot get on the freeway and drive with that one. You just need to start a regen and let it run. It'll probably run even longer, 45, 60 plus minutes or longer, because it's got a lot to burn out. Now there's more lights that you can get with this system. You know, if the combination of the DPF and the check engine are flashing, that means your filter needs to be replaced. If you don't deal with it, then it's gonna get worse. Make sure you deal with your regen lights. If you don't run a regen when you're supposed to, it can actually elevate to the point where it won't let you run a regen, and then you gotta call a mechanic to come out and do it with his computer. So resolve those as quickly as you can. So those are the tips and tricks. Hopefully by you responding to these quick enough, this has been helpful so that you can avoid needing to go to a repair shop right away, and at least you have some peace of mind knowing that you understand a little bit about what's happening there. Good luck.